hidden racism. It's something Preston Fagan hears about every day as president of the local chapter of the NAACP.
Back in the 50s and the 60s, they were open that there were racism. You know, there were signs, "We don't rent to color," and things of that nature. Today, the signs are down, but the problems still exist.
Donald Sterling's racist remarks prove, even in the world of sports, racism still exists in 2014.
When this comes up, it slaps them in the face and it wakes them up and say, wow, we have a problem.
The existence of modern-day racism may not be surprising, but hearing this from the NBA commissioner is.
Effective immediately, I am banning Mr. Sterling for life from any association with the Clippers organization or the NBA.
In terms of sports history, which is the focus here at the David Falk College of Sports and Human Dynamics at SU, it is not unheard of to ban a player or a manager for life. But what is unprecedented is to ban an owner for life while at the same time forcing them to sell their team.
Early in Commissioner Silver's stewardship of the NBA, I think it's the exact kind of move he needed to make to create a statement for not only the owners but for the fans that the kind of behavior that Donald Sterling kind of put on all of us just won't be accepted.
Many want to believe that racism is behind us, but moving forward, we now know it won't be tolerated in major professional sports. Reporting from Syracuse, I'm Dora Scheidel.